Hello guys, welcome back to Techdose, and in this video we will see how to print all possible combination of R elements in a given array of size n. So let us look at the problem statement. The problem statement says that if you have an array of, let's say, n size, here the size is 4 and the 4 elements are 1 2 3 4, and your R value is 2, that means you want to print all the possible combinations of size 2 from the array size n. Then what will be the combinations? In this case, the combination will be 1,2, 1,3, 1,4, 2,3, 2,4 and 3,4. So how do you print it? And how can you solve this problem? Actually, this is a recursion or a backtracking type of problem. And so let us see how to solve it. I will just give you the intuition, and the code will be present in the description section below, so you can check it out. Now, let us take a bigger example. Let us say our element set is having 5 elements, and that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the 5 elements in our element set. And let's say you want to print all the combinations having size 3. So actually, by using mathematical formula, you can find out what will be the number of combinations. It will be 5C3, which will be equals to 10. So we should be able to print 10 combinations which is of size 3, and the number of elements in the set is 5. So NCR is our formula which gives the number of combinations. Now let us see how to print these combinations. Now you can see that every element here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, is having two options, whether they will be included or they won't be included. So if you have, let's say, 5 elements, then either you can include one or you can exclude one. You can include 2 or you can exclude 2. You can include 3 or you can exclude 3, and so on for all the elements. But since you have given R value as 3, you cannot exclude all the elements, or you cannot, let's say, you cannot exclude 3 elements. Because R is equals to 3, you need to have at least 3 elements. So that is the constraint in this question. Okay, so this is what you need to handle. So without wasting any time, let us see how to solve this question. Let's say you are having 5 elements and you want to print all the combinations having 3 elements. Then the first thing which you can do is you can include 1. So if you include 1 as your first element, if you want to include 1, then your node will have 1. This node is saying that your current combination is having 1. So you have included this 1. Now you are left with 4 elements. Now let's say we are traversing from left to right, because you will be traversing from left to right actually. So now you have option to include 2 or to exclude 2. Let us say we include this 2. Then your combination will be 1, 1, 2. Now you are at 3. You have 3 options. Actually, you have 2 options. You can include this 3 or you can exclude this 3. So let's say we included this 3. So when we include this 3, our combination will be 1, 2 and 3. Now it is of size 3. Therefore, we will print this combination 1, 2, 3 and we will stop here. Okay. So we will not go further down the tree since our size is already 3. Now we will backtrack to 1,2. Now when we backtrack to 1,2, we have assumed that we already printed the combination having 3. Now we will leave this 3. Okay, we will leave this 3 and we move to 4. Now we include 4. On including 4, your combination becomes 1,2,4 and you stop here. You don't go further down the tree. We return back to 1,2 after printing this 1,2,4. Now you will leave this 4, since you have printed already the combination including this 4. So the second option is to exclude this 4. So we will exclude this 4, and now we are at 5. So at 5 we will include 5, 1 to 5, and the excluding 5 case is already covered, because when you included this 3, you already excluded 4 and 5. When you included this 4, you already excluded 3 and 5. So all the cases have now been covered of including 3, excluding 3, including 4, excluding 4 and including 5, excluding 5. So you have printed these three elements. You will backtrack to 1, 2. Now let me change the color. Since you have backtracked to 1, 2 and you have printed with all the combinations possible which included this 1, 2, you will again backtrack to 1. Now at 1, you had printed just one case which included this 2. Now you will, instead of including this 2, you will include other elements. So what you will do is you will skip this 2. So when you skip this 2, you will have 3. So in the next case, you will include 3. So when you include 3, the element is 1, 3. So you will move to 4 now. At 4, you have two options, either you include 4 or you exclude 4. So let's say we first include this 4. So when you include this 4, your combination will be 1, 3, 4. And since it is of size 3, so we will stop here, we will print it, and again we will come back to 1, 3. Now when we return back to 1, 3, we already know that we printed a combination containing containing this 4. So what we will do is we will skip this 4 for the next time because we have already printed 1 including this 4. So we will exclude this 4, we move to 5. Now at 5 we have two options, either to include it or to exclude it. So we will include it first. 5 is included, your combination is 1, 3, 5, it is of size 3, we will print it and we will come back to 1, 3. Now excluding 5 case is already covered because when we included 4 to 1, 3, then that was the case where we actually excluded 5. And when we included 5 to 1, 3, then it was 1, 3, 5, and that was the case where we excluded 4. So both the cases have now been covered and therefore we will come back to this 1. Now we are at 1, and at 1 we have already covered all the cases including this 2 and then including this 3. So now what we have is we have another option including this 4. So we will skip this 2, this 3, we will not include both of them and we directly include 4. So when we include 4, the element set will be 1, 4. Now we have included this 4, now we are left with just a single element 5. So when we are just left with a single element 5 and R value is 3, we will have to include it and there is no other option. So 1, 4, 5, we will print it and we will go back to 1, 4. When we are at 1, 4 and we have already included 5, there is no other element to the right hand side, so we can't do anything else and so we will come back to 1. So all the cases we using this 1 have been covered. Since we wanted to print only the combinations of length 3, so we need at least 3 elements, so we can exclude maximum of 2 elements. So we had a total of 5 elements and we can exclude a maximum of 2 elements. So by using these 3 branches, actually we excluded 2 elements. In this branch 2, actually we were excluding 3 and 4. In this 3, we excluded 2 and 4, and in 4, we excluded 2 and 3. So no more branches are even possible. So we will go back to the root. Okay, so all the combinations starting with 1 have been printed and these are 6 number of combinations. So let me now change the color. Okay, now what I will do is I will leave this 1. Since we already included 1, let me write it here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Since we already included this 1, so the second option is not to include this 1. Including this 1, we printed these 6 combinations. Now we will exclude this 1. Now we actually have these 4 elements to consider and we will take the branch which will start with 2. So starting with 2, we will print now. So we will include 2, the combination will be 2 now. From this 2, when you reach 3, you have two options, either you can include 3 or you can exclude 3. So when you include 3, it will be 2, 3. And at 2, 3, you have two options, either to include 4 or to exclude 4. If you include 4, then your combination become 2, 3, 4. Now, it is of size 3, so you will print it and come back to 2, 3. Now, since you have already included this 4, you will exclude this 4. Move to next element 5. You include this 5 and you print 2, 3 and 5. It is of length 3, you come back to 2, 3. already both the cases are covered, including 4 and not including 4. Actually, including 5 is equivalent to saying that in excluding 4 case. Okay. So, you have printed all the cases of 2, 3. You will go back to 2. Now, when you are at 2, you already included 3. So, including 3 case is covered. So, what you will do next is you will exclude these 3 and you move to 4. So, when you exclude these 3, then you are left with 2 elements to cover and 2 elements are left. Only 4 and 5 are left in your element set and you need a size of 3 and you have a current size of 1. So, you will have to include both these elements. So, I will include 4, it becomes 2, 4 and I will include 5, it becomes 2, 4, 5. And there is no other case possible. Because you cannot exclude 4 and expect that you will reach a size of 3. Okay. So that was the case because we have already excluded 1. By taking this branch, orange branch, we have already excluded this 1. So one element is gone. And now from these 2, when we are taking this branch of 4, we are assuming that we have already not included this 3. So 1 was already excluded, 3 is excluded in this branch by taking this 4th branch, the 4 number branch. So 2 elements are excluded, we are left with 3 elements, they must be included. Now we backtrack to the root. Now when we are at root, we have already printed all the cases starting with 1, we have already printed all the cases starting with 2. Starting with 1 we have 6 combinations, starting with 2 we have 3 combinations. Now we will see starting with 3. We will start with 3. So starting with 3 you can see that we have just 3 elements. So there will be no choices, but we will have to include each and every element. So 3 will be included, 4 will be included and 5 will be included. And this will be printed and we will return back to root again. So these are the 10 combinations which are actually possible to print given n size is 5, elements 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and r size is 3. So I hope there is no doubt left for this problem. This is actually pretty simple to solve by using recursion and backtracking. Now let us see the time complexity and the space complexity of this problem. So what will be the time complexity? If let's say r equals to 1, then ncr value will be equals to actually nc1, which will be equals to n. If r value is let's say some k, then the time complexity will be of order of nck. Okay. And if r value is equals to n, then time complexity will be ncn, which will be equals to 1. So this is about the time complexity. Actually these many are the ncr are the number of leaf nodes actually, and the number of internal nodes will also depend on r value, since r will define the depth of this tree. Since if you have n elements, then depth of the tree will be n minus r. This will be the depth of the tree. In this case, you had 5 elements and your r value was 3, therefore depth of the tree was actually 2. You had 2 depth of internal node, 0, 1, 2 was the depth. So in this case, you had 2 depth and the depth will be n minus r. So space complexity will also depend on r and end value and it will be of the order of n minus r. It will be the stack calls which will determine the space size. Okay. So I hope you are able to understand this problem. If you have any type of doubt, then feel free to comment below and I will try to help you as soon as possible. Like and share our video and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of this programming videos. See you on our next video. Thank you.